Brand new evidence linked to the disappearance of the king salmon suggests that salmon sharks are an important predator. But do the numbers stack up?
Do there seem to be enough of them in the water to significantly make an impact on the king salmon populations?
With a top speed of 50 miles an hour, the salmon shark is a faster and more agile relative of the great white. I investigated salmon sharks a few years ago, and I've caught up with Boone Hodgin, a salmon shark expert in Prince William Sound. The sharks congregate in this area, waiting to ambush the migrating salmon as they travel from the ocean into the rivers. And since it's salmon running season, the sharks should be here right now. I'm going to drop a line in the water to see what's down there. I prepare myself for battle.
Anticipation tinged almost with a bit of dread. There are certain fish, they're just so powerful that you almost don't want to be in contact with them. If it's a prolonged fight, then this will just take some of the strain off my back and my arms. I almost want to be looking back on today, as long as today is a successful day, but I have to actually go through the process of living today first. It will be fun as well, if when it happens, but it's going to be mixed in with some pain, I think.
I'm going to slap this around your waist.
Yep.
As a secondary line,
yeah.
Just in case you slip out,
yeah.
We can reel you back in.
Okay.
With shark and all.
Down it goes. 10, 20.
At this time of year, the salmon sharks could be anywhere from 20 to 200 feet deep.
What I've been told to expect is either this will just get slammed down with no warning, or there will be a slow, steady increase in tension. And either one of those two things could happen at any moment, or several hours could pass without anything happening at all. This is the interesting frozen moment that you get stuck in this type of situation.
I keep the bait moving to attract attention.
Lift it up. Bump it down. Lift it up. Bump it down. I thought I felt a bump.
But the bait hasn't been touched.
80, 90, lift it up, bump it down.
I try different depths.
Down a little bit shallow, about 100 feet down.
And multiple locations. I'm starting to wonder if the sharks are here at all.
So 2 days on the water, full days, long days, and not a single sign of salmon shark. Not a fin on the surface, and nothing on the sonar either. Which leaves me very surprised, puzzled.
In my investigation so far, the salmon shark seems to be the most plausible explanation for the disappearing king salmon. But if I can't find any sharks, that theory is blown. Maybe I've missed the salmon runs and the sharks have already gone. The next day, I decide to switch strategy and equipment to check the salmon are still here.
Yes. Don't think this is a salmon. Oh, wait a minute.
It's a coho.
It is a coho. Ah, it's off. A long enough glimpse of it to see what it was. That was a nice coho salmon.